I'll have you relax your arm down as much as you can.
The transition into the next phase, 1B3, will look a lot like the vaccine process happening already. Many healthcare workers already got shots at their hospitals. Many teachers are getting theirs at district-organized events. Next, it's ag workers and grocery store workers' turn.
The few kind of areas where we're focused on around March 5th, it's administered largely on-site or special clinics. Like, so we go to JBS in Cargill, and it's on-site for employees. Most of the grocery workers are be able to be done through pharmacies.
Take Safeway pharmacies, for example, weeks now into vaccine administration.
We've been doing that since really the first of the year, so right after the Christmas holidays.
And next week, their own employees become eligible for shots as grocery workers.
It's going to be a really overall a very simple process. We know who our associates are. We know, when they're going to want a vaccine. And we'll be scheduling it via an appointment basis, just like we do our current phases.
For this group, March 5th marks a turning point.
We have associates of all ages, all demographics, and who in several have medical conditions. And they put their lives at risk every time they go to the store, just so that you can get your gallon of milk, your produce for the week, your groceries for the week. And they're there day in and day out, working really hard to take care of our customers.
Each new phase means new logistics. Safeway says adding their own employees should be pretty easy.
I'll be honest, that's probably the easiest population to vaccinate. So we're in a good spot.
Jennifer Meckles, 9 News.
For Ag-